Hello and welcome. Thanks for joining us. We've got a perfect night for baseball on the show. It's the Cleveland Guardians going up against the Oakland Athletics. First pitch coming your way next. First pitch coming up. Our starter in this one, Alex Wood.
Yeah, his ERA last year was a little worse than average, so definitely be looking for better results this season. One of the keys is just being able to have a consistent delivery and to be able to repeat that delivery so you can hit the spots that you want to hit and have a higher chance of being successful.
Ready to go now. Stepping up for the Guardians, Stephen Kwan, Noda. And he takes it himself for the out. Here's the Guardians lineup now. A really frustrating showing for them in their last game. Lots of traffic on the bases, but they left a ton of runners on base. Couldn't cash in their chances, Chris.
They had plenty of chances. There's nobody to blame it on but themselves offensively. They just did a poor job converting in those situations. You have to figure out what's your plan going to be. Maybe watch some tape from the last game. Make the adjustment. So if you get those opportunities in this one, you've got a much better chance of scoring some runs.
Miles Straw, batting with one down, takes a strike. Ball. Just off the outside edge. He swings and hits a fly ball, center field. Ruiz snags it on the run.
Hey, man, four pitches, two outs. That is an excellent pace.
Number 22.
Here's Josh Naylor. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average. But one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. On the ground, right side, Noda. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Guardians go down 1-2-3, and the A's will get their first opportunity in a scoreless ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here with my pal Singy, and towing the slab in this one, Shane Bieber. What do you look for here?
Well, last year kind of around the league average in terms of ERA, and you know what? That's why you have five different spots in the starting rotation. You've got to have people round things out, and not everyone's going to pitch like a number one or number two every outing or every season. But last year, he gave his team an opportunity and a chance to win every time he took them out on average. And when you look at that kind of performance, it has a place on every ball club.
As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm delivers, Esteyuri Ruiz in the box now. No balls and a strike. There's a foul ball. The 0-2. Caught him looking for the K.
Wow, that's a tough call for the hitter, but the pitcher will take that all day long. Not quite in the strike zone, but he found a spot that the umpire is going to, at least for now, allow him to get that call. So hitters are going to have to make an adjustment, but pitchers are going to learn from those things and really try to exploit them if they can.
At the plate, Ryan Noda. Jimenez tosses to first.
He's out.
Two up, two down. And time now to check out the A's lineup. Two outs, base is empty. Zach Gelof up next for the A's. In there for strike one. Clobber to right field. Jump out front, it's 1-0.
excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
So two down, Brent Rooker up next for the A's. Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Sizes this one up and puts the squeeze on that one. That is the inning. Oakland gets one on this homer. It's now 1-0. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. And we're back. Leading here's Jose Ramirez.
The third baseman.
Wood, a 6'4 lefty, Ramirez. 215 pounds. He joined the team as a free agent. A wide to kick the pitch. Fouled off down the right side. The lefty fires. Pitch misses. Now 1-2. And he can't make the play. But the throw to first gets him easily. And that's the first out.
That is hit. The white fielder, number 10.
Laureano comes up to hit.
Laureano
hitting fifth in today's lineup. And he found his way onto the team after being claimed off waivers. In there at the knees. It's 0-1.
Well, the key to his success is getting ahead early in the count. He cannot afford to go deep in the counts. Doesn't have a ton of swing and miss stuff, so he's going to have to work efficiently.
Inside, almost got him. Ground ball right side. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And Laureano is retired.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over.
David Fry digs in for the Guardians. Two RBIs last night. Two of the three runs they scored in the game. First pitch just misses. Fry, 28 years old. And he was drafted in the seventh round back in 2018. On the ground, and it goes just foul. That one fouled off. Right side, hard hit. Gathers and throws to first. And that's the third out. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. They're down 1-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. Bottom of the second. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Seth Brown. Bieber in his sixth season, 28 years old. And he won a gold glove in 2022. Bieber back to work. Swing and a miss.
I think he was a little excited there. Saw the fastball, but needed a stepladder to get to that one. He's going to have to tighten it back up. He wants to have a good at bat.
Time to look at our umpiring crew in this one. Kenny Jansen behind the plate.
Yeah, and expect a little inconsistency on the corners. He doesn't make any wild calls, but he does give and take there a little bit. So he doesn't have the easiest strike zone to figure out, especially as the game goes on, when you're expecting it to become more consistent.
Laureano snags it, and there's one down. What about some no-nos? Like, you can't call the umpire Paloo the way you do in Little League or high school, right?
Yeah. Even in the minor leagues, you'll learn quickly. You call the umpire Blue. You better learn his name. And that's just part of being a professional player and even a major league player.
That one hammered, but pulled foul. as the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of one all more. Four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
Off the plate.
That's great.
Next offering is in for a strike. And another ball. A's leading by a run. Bottom half of inning number two. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. And the right-hander deals. Gets a piece. And stays alive. The pitch. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Battling here as he fouls it away. Hit hard, that gets through. So he ends up with a hit after seeing a lot of pitches. That was a good bat.
The designated hitter, Miguel Andujar.
Here's Miguel Andujar. Two hits in the game last night. The plate, and it's 0-1.
0-1.
Man at first, one away. And a foul ball. Now fly ball to right center. Laureano makes the catch.
Batting it. The third baseman.
Jordan Diaz. Up next for the A's. Right through there for a strike. Soderstrom off of first with two away.
No.
That one missed.
One ball, one strike.
Swing and a miss, and that's that. One left for Oakland, but they still lead it 1-0. What you waiting for? Come and get it. Come and get it. What you waiting for? Back here in the East Bay, onto the third inning. Here's Andrés Giménez. The wind of the pitch. That one at the knees for a strike.
No ball. One strike.
The wind of the pitch. Bounce to the right side. Leadoff man out. Retired here in the third.
Batting it. The shortstop. Brian
Rocchio. Here's Brian Rocchio, a switch hitter batting right. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Good eye right there. The Guardians trailing by a run. We're here in the top half of inning number three. And that one hit to first. A flip to the pitcher. And a couple of quick outs.
That is it.
The pitcher. Bo Naylor.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. Pitches outside, ball one. Good chase that time. Two outs, base is empty. Outside corner for a strike.
In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
Swing and a pop-up. Diaz moves under it. Makes the catch, inning over. The Guardians go down in order. They trail here 1-0. As we go to the last of the third, digging in for Oakland, Alexis Diaz. The pitch. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. And a pitch. And a foul ball. One gone, bottom of the third inning.
Now batting, center fielder, S.A. Urey.
So the batting order turns over. Now here's the leadoff hitter for the A's, S.A. Urey Ruiz. And first offering is fouled off. He delivers. Line drive, and that's a base hit out of the center field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Didn't exactly square that one up, but sometimes you don't have to. Now there are a lot of nicknames people have attached to hits like that. Looper, Flair, Duck Score, Bondard, etc. But whatever you want to call it, it's a knock. And those are the ones that will make you smile as a hitter just about every time. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
And here is Ryan Noda. Foul ball there. Grounder might be two. Off balance feed, there's one. And that's two. One hit in the inning, but no one left. Three innings complete. It's the A's one, and the Guardians nothing. Start of the fourth, and now here is Stephen Kwan.
Stephen Kwan.
Wood back to work. And foul ball. And now the lefty. And that one sliced foul.
ultimate strikeout, he can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
And up next for Cleveland, Miles Straw. Turned on, but foul wide of third. One down, base is empty. Fought off foul. The Guardians still looking for their first hit in this one. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. That leaves him without a throw, and they don't get the out.
The first baseman, number 22.
One gone, runner at first. Naylor. And here's the first baseman, Josh Naylor. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Swing and a line drive curling foul down the right side. Wood with a move to first. And he's back safely. Tying run is at first. Top half of inning number four. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out of the center field. Lead runner makes the turn at second. To third, not in time. And it's runners at the corners with one gone.
Well, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but... He did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
Now it's Jose Ramirez. 0 for 1 so far. First pitch misses.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, Boo.
The Guardians down by a run here in the second game of the series.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
On the ground, right side. And it's just foul. That was close.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. He fouls it off. We'll do it again.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there.
On the ground, right side. Nota to second. Got it. The double play cuts down the potential tying run. So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and one left on base. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the A's one and the Guardians nothing. And we're back. John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Zach Gallen. Flips the corner. Strike one.
He's been pitching well, but we'll see what kind of adjustment the hitters make this second time through the order. We'll know if he's got really good stuff in this one or not.
Next pitch is outside.
Two balls, two strikes.
And another ball. The line and the pitch. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. again. And it remains 3-2. Look out. That ball is smoke.
Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines just to ensure safety for the fans. Nice thing as a player, you want to look up and see a fan get there.
Fly ball down the line. And it's off the wall, but foul. And he deals. This to center field. Straw has a beat on it. Hauls it in for the out. And there's one away. So here's the cleanup hitter for Oakland. Brent Rooker, 0-for-1 with a fly out to center. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Here comes a pitch. They say it went.
0-2.
One out, base is empty. And down on strikes he goes. That's out number two.
Well, clearly just anxious right there, and understandably so. In an 0-2 count, you feel like you've got a lot of plate to cover, and you don't want to strike out, and you end up striking out. That's just one of those pitches where it's not over the plate, but because you committed to it as it was leaving his hand, by the time you realized it wasn't going to be in the zone, it's too late to hold up your swing.
Just missed. That's down and in.
He hasn't fallen behind in the count like this all day. He's in danger of walking his first batter right here.
That just missed. He walked him on four pitches.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Soderstrom in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. First offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
Two outs. And a base hit up the middle. Throw in hopes the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. Diving on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't screw it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
First and second, two down. Next is the designated hitter, Miguel Andujar. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Pitch. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Kicks and fires. That one misses. And the count 1-2.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
Bows it off, still 1-2. Two on, two outs. That's foul off to the right side, keeps the AB going.
Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Good job to fight that one off. Smoked on the ground a second. Toss to Naylor, and the inning is over. A's strand a couple, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Ready now for the fifth inning. And now, Ramon Laureano.
Ramon Laureano.
The pitch. No. Just missed. In the air, out towards right center. Rooker moving under this one. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away.
Now batting, the designated hitter, David.
And now the DH, Fry. David Fry, grounded out his first time.
Ball
just
one.
Off the inside edge.
Ball
and
two.
Another ball. One down, base is empty. And a foul ball. Makes the count 2-1. And a pitch. And a foul ball, third base side.
Ball
next
three.
Pitch is outside.
Ball count.
Kicks and deals. Fights it off. He'll see another. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. To third, Diaz. Fires across the
That's
diamond.
Out.
He didn't make things easy for him there, but they still get the out.
The second baseman, Andres Jimenez.
Now it's the second baseman, Andres Jimenez. Grounded out his first time. That catches the corner.
Jimenez.
A multi-gold glove award winner, 25 years old, and he was born in Venezuela.
One ball, one strike.
Two down, nobody on.
Ball two. 2-1.
And right back to the mound. And that is
He's
that.
Out.
Guardians fail to score. They still trail 1-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Jordan Diaz. And a pitch. And there's a foul ball. The 0-1. That one fouled off.
Ball.
Almost got him. Wouldn't chase that time.
2-2.
Out to short. Toss to Naylor.
Out.
And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
The batter, not shortstop.
Let Miss Diaz down.
Diaz.
Grounded out back to the pitcher his first time.
No.
The shortstop takes a ball.
Just missing off the plate there, according to the umpire. And out there on the mound, maybe trying to get an explanation. Can't say he's convinced, but it looks like he's accepted it.
That's in there. And the count 1-1.
One.
And the righty deals.
Ball.
Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number 5. Check swing on the 2-2. Appeal to first. And that's going to be ruled a swing.
The center fielder.
And the batter down. Este Yuri Ruiz. 1-2.
Ruiz.
That's in there. 1-1. Hawaii to kick the pitch. And downstairs.
1-2.
And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Naylor makes the catch. And that is the third out of the inning. And the A's are gone in order. But they're on top, 1-0. Back here in the East Bay, top 6. So in now for Cleveland, Ryan Rocchio. The lefty fires. Ball, ball. One there.
Ball. On paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from. Tonight, his slider has been really impressive. I mean, tight spin. Seems like the hitters aren't picking it up out of the hand.
And another ball.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
That misses the zone. And the count is 3-1.
Now on this 3-ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
And a pitch. Taps softly to the right side. He takes it on his own.
He's out.
Leadoff man retired in the 6th.
Now batting. The catcher.
Bo Naylor digs in for the Guardians. 0-1 with a flyout. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter. And that one fouled off. The Guardians trailing by a run, and we're at the top half of the 6th. The pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. So now back to the top of the order.
He was all over that one. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit.
Now here is Stephen Kwan.
Struck out on just 3 pitches last time.
Edge of the zone for a strike. 0-1. At the belt and fires.
1-1.
With the go-ahead run at the plate, here in the 2nd game of the series. In the air, left side. Brings it in. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Miles Straw. That's a strike. It's 0-1. And here it comes. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Naylor leads off first with two down to the inning. And that one moves his speed. Two outs. That one hit to right on his way over. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is that. So another good inning for him on the mound. Six shutout innings now. It's the A's one and the Guardians nothing. This is redemption. Heard what I said. I'm on a mission. I ball. Back in Oakland, bottom of the sixth inning, digging in for Oakland, Ryan Noda.
Ryan Noda.
The wind of the pitch. That clips the zone. That's strike one.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
And the right-hander deals. Foul ball. The wind of the pitch.
Ball
and
one.
That's off the inside edge.
One ball.
And the count
two
is
strike.
One and two.
No.
Just misses with that one.
It's a good take.
And now two and two. And they'll do it again. Left-hand batter waits. There's a swing and a drive. That's down. One hops off the wall. Throws to second. And that's a leadoff double.
Put a great swing on that ball. Took the barrel right to it. Nice extension as well. 105 exit velocity. That tells you everything you need to know about that swing.
Next to hit, Zach Gallen. His homer earlier is responsible for the only runs they've scored in this one.
Yeah, forget small ball. They're kind of living and dying by the long ball so far in this one.
Ball just outside. Missed. Double-barreled action in the bullpen. Trevor Stephan up and loosening in the pen. Morgan also throwing. Runner in scoring position. Nobody out here in the bottom of the sixth.
That's
in there for a strike at the top of the zone. Right-hander kicks, deals. Comes up empty. That's strike two.
1-2.
Back to right. Laureano makes a nice running catch.
Now back. The white fielder.
Brent Rooker up next for the A's.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
Yeah, there's a ball. And it's second. Strike on the outside. And it's 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
That looked like a case of deciding to swing no matter what. That pitch was way up. Nice job of the pitcher knowing that this hitter's looking for something up that he can drive, but he just expanded the zone to his advantage.
Slider got him for strike three.
He came out of his mechanics there. Yeah, typically he likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
So here's Brown at the plate. He's 0 for 1. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. The A's strand one, but they lead it 1-0. And we're back. We go to the top of the seventh, and now the first baseman, Josh Naylor. Wood back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Scott Alexander, the veteran southpaw, is getting ready to come on if needed. Airsick, the right-hander, also getting loose. Looking to get the tying run on base. And that one fouled off. And now the lefty. Right back to him on the mound. That's the first out in the top of the seventh.
That's a huge defensive play in the late stages of the game. It might not be the most challenging we've seen today, but it needed to be made. That's helping your team.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Jose Ramirez. That one's in there. That's strike one.
Well, I'm impressed with that challenge pitch right there. Even with this slim lead, this guy's not afraid to go right after these hitters.
Kicks and fires. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Here's the 0-2.
Ball.
Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Trying to hold a one-run lead here in the top half of inning number seven. The pitch. And another ball.
This guy's a fun guy to watch taking at bat. He just battles up there. He doesn't take a pitch off at all. Makes it so difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put him away.
Two on the way. The other way, Noda. And he handles that's it himself out for the out.
The right fielder, number 10, Ramon Laureano.
Here's Ramon Laureano. Slapped foul. Two down, nobody on. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Ruiz makes the play, and that is that. Nothing doing for the Guardians there. And it remains 1-0. Set for the last leading half of the seventh. Leading off, Tyler Soderstrom. As he turns on the rubber, and with that good live arm deliverance. And there's a breaking ball that drops in there.
I really like how he's been attacking hitters early in at bats. He's throwing strikes on the first pitch to over 70% of the guys he's faced in this one.
Righty to the plate. Line drive, base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
Having himself a really nice game at the plate. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. That's it for Shane Bieber, and he leaves in a one-run game. New pitcher coming up. We'll be back in a minute. Trevor Stephan gets the ball now. Please.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Miguel Andujar, the next to hit.
Ball.
That's a little bit low.
One ball, no strike.
Runner at first with no outs here. Lifted in the air right center field. Laureano flashes the leather on the running catch. Now the third baseman, Jordan Diaz. That clips the inside corner.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
And that's outside. And now it's even one ball.
One strike.
The pitch.
Two.
Swing and a pop-up. Jimenez settles under it. Corrals it. Two down. And it's Alexis Diaz.
The shortstop. Alexis Diaz.
And there's the strike. In there across the letters.
Establishing both ends of the zone is critical. Most times guys are wanting to get hitters out down, but if you can get them to look up, get a called strike, that's going to make that strike zone a lot bigger.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And he's down on strikes. That's the third out. One left for Oakland. They lead it 1-0. And welcome back to the ballpark. We go to the eighth, and now David Fry. As the lefty gets to work. That one misses. Ball one. Oakland's bullpen has some movement. Zach Jackson, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. Here comes a pitch. And that's downed away.
Two balls, no strike.
This guy's seen two changeups in a row. Could be a little vulnerable for a fastball right here.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. 2-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. Kicks and deals. Swing and this one's bounced on the ground. Rolls across the diamond. Leadoff man is out here in the eighth.
That play won't be trending on social media later on, but it's still important to execute it to perfection. This game is a lot harder than it looks, Parker.
Andrés Giménez digs in now.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate. Try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
No ball.
Holding on to a one-run lead, and we're in the top of the eighth. There's a hit.
Always feels amazing getting a job done when the team needs you to come through. It's just bigger than your own individual stats. You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive in the center field. And now a chance to maybe get creative on offense with good speed on first. Now for Oakland, Scott Alexander.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight end
and win the ball
game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here. Brian Rocchio digs in for the Guardians. Step off throw to first. Jimenez back on a dive.
He's got plus speed. But in this situation, all eyes are going to be over there trying to keep his lead tight.
First offering misses badly for ball one. And he deals. Late swing fouled off. One run game, one out, one on. With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here. That one misses. Ball two. Runner takes off. Pitch is low. Throw. Save. That was close, but StatCast shows us why he so often seems to be on the safe side of these steal attempts, Chris.
Yeah, you see that plus speed, and he needed every last bit of it to swipe that bag. Such a threat on the bases.
So the tying run at second. This ball's chopped to the ground. Diaz. Whips it across.
Out.
Two gone now.
If you want to be a great defense, you have to deliver consistently. Okay. It doesn't matter how many highlight reel plays you make if you can't execute the small stuff, just like we saw.
Here's the catcher, Bo Naylor. That one finds the zone. Strike one. Jimenez at second with two down. Edge of the zone for a strike, and the count is 0-2.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
And the pitch. Slider misses outside. That's downstairs and outside. Two outs and one in scoring position.
Ball.
Next offering misses down and away.
They try to get him to go. Chase the pitch down and away, but he wouldn't bite.
Stephen Kwan, next to bat for Cleveland.
Sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Ready for the bottom of the eighth, and now the center fielder, Esteyuri Ruiz. The pitch, And a swing and a miss.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
Off the mark there, and that is ball one. Righty delivers. That's off the mark. Two and one.
Two ball, one strike.
And a pitch. And a good eye there.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
And here it comes. And now the count is full. And another power hitter lurking in the on-deck circle. And the righty deals. High fly ball, shallow right field. Laureano makes the catch. And there's one down.
Up next for Oakland.
Let's get it.
The first baseman.
Ryan Noda. Up next for the A's. One for three. Stephen, 28 years old, and he was a third-round pick back in 2017. And it's fouled away.
A little early on that fastball. I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch on this next one.
One down, base is empty. And that one fouled off. And misses. It's a strikeout.
Now back.
Here's the second baseman, Zach Gelof. He's already homered in this game. That one missed. Two down, nobody on. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. The next pitch misses. And the count is 2-0.
No, just that's missed. Ball. Three balls, no strike.
See if he gives him anything to hit here.
Yeehaw!
That one's in there, and that is strike one. And there's ball four.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is if you are the offensive side of it.
Rooker stands in now and watches strike one.
Well, if he's going to steal second, you want him to go early in the count. That way he's not a distraction to the hitter at the plate. Go ahead and get it out of the way so the hitter can focus on the pitch.
Oh, and two now. No. And that just misses.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
Two outs. In the air, center field. Straw has a beat on it. And that is that.
Knock, knock on my door. Is this redemption for my soul?
Chance at his first save of the year. So digging in, Stephen Kwan. Crisp baseball. today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. Left-hand hitter waits. And foul off.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
The pitch. Ball. And it is 2-1.
2-1.
Outside. Next pitch is outside. Miles Straw to bat next. Hater deals. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes. Here comes a 3-2. And the tying run is on base. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk.
They're not ready to go home quite yet.
Here's the center fielder, Miles Straw.
Miles Straw.
Bunting, but that's a foul ball. Squares, pushes at it, misses it. It's a strike. 0-2. At the belt and fires.
No.
That one at 95 missed up top, and that's ball one. Trying to close out a one-run lead here at the top of the ninth. That misses the zone. It's 2-2.
Still just the second batter of the inning, and on the mound, he's already thrown 13 pitches. They've got him working hard out there.
2-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Two now. And another ball.
So here we go. Base runner at first. Could be running on the pitch. He's got good enough speed to steal the bag to get in scoring position, even if it's a swing and miss at the plate.
That one the other way, and a base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on the line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Now that sets up a huge at-bat in this ballgame.
And now it's Josh Naylor. That one finds the zone. Strike one.
Well, they're applying pressure. Quality at bats, quality swings right now, and see this offense doing it one man to the next. Showing a lot of fight right now. They're making it difficult for the back end of this bullpen to close out this game.
0-1 now.
That's the ball.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
Ball to strike.
Ball two.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
With the tying run at second, go ahead, run at first. Here in the second game of the series. And strike two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Jose Ramirez will hit next. Three groundouts already. He's 0 for 3.
Well, if he gets the save here, he's going to have earned it. Just getting through this hitter is going to be a challenge enough.
Bottom of the zone and a called strike.
No late ball. In the game, everyone gets a little tighter. A way to get ahead on a really good hitter right there.
Two on, one out.
Ball. One ball, two strikes.
Ball chase that time.
Going to lay off that pitch down.
Swings and misses on the fastball up in the zone for the strikeout. So they're down to their final out. Stepping up for the Guardians, Ramon Laureano. Trying to deliver as the hero. There's a strike.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. When you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it. But this is where they earn their keep.
They're down to their final strike.
No ball. Two strikes.
One strike away. Swing and a miss and out. The tying and go-ahead runs are left aboard as this one is over.
Well, this was all about the pitching and defense. Outstanding job of the pitchers, really attacking hitters, trusting what the catcher was putting down, and trusting the players standing behind him to make the plays defensively. Sometimes you want to see a high-scoring game, but sometimes you can appreciate the artistic beauty of what these pitchers did on the mound today.